Do you wish you could get paid back for your adoption? We all know that adoption is very expensive. In this video, I am going to show you how to get your money back for your adoption expenses. For the best adoption advice and child advocacy, make sure to subscribe to my channel and hit that bell button to be notified when I post a new video every week. Hey, my name is Lucrece. I am an adoption lawyer, and I help hopeful adoptive parents become well-informed so that they can start their adoption journey with confidence. So welcome to my channel. So there is a way to get your money back for expenses paid towards your adoption. How do you ask? Drum roll, please. Through the adoption tax credit. I know this can seem very complicated, so I'll break it down for you. You're welcome. So what is the adoption tax credit anyway? It's a tax-related benefit that the IRS allows for any qualifying costs or fees that you spend on an adoption. So really, it includes fees that you pay to an adoption agency, to an attorney, birth mothers, really any type of, they're pretty lenient on what the expenses are that you can qualify for. And so you get a tax benefit for those expenses that you pay towards pursuing your adoption. So the way it works is that the tax credit is deducted from the bottom line tax that you owe to the IRS. So for most families, it looks like you're getting credit back in the form of a refund from the IRS. So how much is this adoption tax credit? Well, the IRS has increased this amount in 2021, and the amount is now $14,660, which in 2020, it was actually $14,300. So they've increased it, which is great. So you can get a credit of up to $14,660 per child for adoption expenses that you incurred pursuing your adoption. The tax credit that you actually receive is the total dollar amount for the adoption expenses that you incurred. So let's say you spent $10,000 total for your adoption, you'll get $10,000 back for that in your tax credit. If you spent $14,000, you'll get $14,000 back in the tax credit. But if you spent over the $14,660 for your adoption expenses, you're not going to get that excess back, right? You only get up to the $14,660. So who qualifies to get the tax credit? Any family in the U.S. who has adopted a child qualifies for this tax credit. So the adoptions that are included here are going to be newborn adoptions, foster care adoptions, international adoptions. It does not cover adopting a relative. So doing like a step-parent adoption would not be included in that. You can also go on the IRS website, which I will link below, to find out more about that tax credit. To get the full tax credit amount, you have to have an adjusted gross income of $216,660. If you make more than that, the adoption credit starts to phase out, right? So you get less in the credit the more you make over that amount. And that adoption tax credit gets lower and lower until you reach an adjusted gross amount of $256,660. And at that point, you will not be receiving the adoption tax credit at all. You might be thinking now, that's cool, Lucrece, but how do I actually get this money back? So here's an example. Here's a basic scenario of a family who has not adopted a child. They have an adjusted gross income of $100,000. They have income tax withholdings of $20,000. They have tax owing of $19,000 and an expected IRS refund of $1,000. Now, here's a scenario of a family who has adopted a child. So again, the adjusted gross income is $100,000. Tax withholdings were $20,000. Tax owed is $19,000. They have an allowed adoption tax credit of $10,000, which is the total dollar amount of how much they actually spent in pursuing their adoption. This then reduces their tax owing to $9,000, and their expected IRS refund is now going to be $11,000. So as you can see, that makes a huge difference when you get that adoption tax credit. Is this helping you guys at all? Let me know in the comments below. Now, there is a special rule for adopting a child from foster care who has been deemed by the state to be a special needs child. If the state has deemed that child to be special needs and the state will be providing an adoption subsidy for the adoptive parents, the adoptive parents can claim the entire full amount of the adoption tax credit, the $14,660, regardless of whether they spent any money for their adoption expenses and regardless of whether they're receiving the adoption subsidy, which is pretty amazing. So let's look at that example again. Here is that family's adjusted gross income of $100,000, They got tax withholdings of $20,000. They've got tax owing of $19,000. They get the allowed adoption tax credit for the full amount of $14,660, even if they have zero adoption expenses. They still get that money. That then reduces their tax owing to $4,340. And their expected IRS refund is now going to be $15,660. Wow, that's amazing. And that, my friends, is how you get your money back for your adoption. One more thing that I want to mention is that the adoption tax credit is not a refundable credit, which means that if you spent over the $14,660 that's allowed for the adoption tax credit, you can still, you'll just get a credit for that amount up to $14,660. And then the next year, you can ask for the rest of the money that you spent, okay? So let's say you spent $20,000 on your adoption. This year, you can get the tax credit for the $14,660, which will reduce your tax owing. And then the next year, you can ask for the rest of the amount. So it balances out for you in that way so that you still get your money back. You'll just do it incrementally, especially if you spend over that amount, right? Now, of course, you want to talk to your accountant. I am not an accountant. Again, you know I'm an adoption lawyer, but I understand kind of how this works. But you want to talk to your accountant to make sure that if you finalize your adoption this year, that you make sure to take advantage of that tax credit so that you get a refund back for the adoption expenses that you made this year to adopt your kiddo. This makes a huge difference, as you can see, because although adoption is expensive, this is an easy way for you to offset the cost of your expenses, and it's available to literally every single adopted family in the United States who obviously qualifies. But it's available to anybody who adopts. That's amazing. Now, if you want to learn more about how to adopt in the United States and little tips and tricks that I teach my students in my adoption program, click the link below in the description box to get your hand on my free guide. Also, if you want to join a community of hopeful adoptive parents just like you who are starting the process, they're learning how to do it the right way and they're getting resources, make sure to join my Facebook group, which has been growing like crazy. You can find the link in the description box below as well. Now, if you like this video, click that like button, okay? Be sure to subscribe and share with your friends. Thanks for watching. Bye.